Hello everyone. Today's lesson is going to be from inside a subway train. Greetings for the first time. Quick overview of what we'll be going over. We have a dialogue here. And then we have some vocabulary, close up expressions, and nationality. I'm going to be going in order from left to right, top to bottom. So starting from the dialogue, I'm going to quickly read through the conversation from inside a subway train. Let me just line this up.
저 이거 올림픽 공원에 가죠?
네. 외국인이세요?
네. 일본에서 왔어요.
그런데 한국말을 잘 하시네요?
아니요. 잘 못해요.
언제 한국에 오셨어요?
일주일 전에 왔어요.
That's over here.
지금 어디에 가세요?
콘서트에 가요.
그러세요? 저도 거기에 가요.
그럼 이따가 내릴 때 알려주세요.
네, we'll go over some of the vocabulary words from the dialogue. So, foreigner. You're going to hear this a lot if you are a foreigner in Korea. If you look like you're Korean and you're not Korean, and Korean people try to talk to you, you can just say, I'm a 외국인.
나는 외국인이에요.
You can say that as well. 외국인.
일본. 그런데 한국말.
So speaking Korean, the Korean language. 한국말
잘하다,
못하다.
언제,
한국,
오다.
일주일
전
지금
어디
콘서트
저도
거기
있다가
Some new expressions learned from the dialogue is, are you a foreigner? You can ask that. Or perhaps it's more likely that you're going to hear this. It's good to know what the phrase means here, the question.
외국인,
so again, foreigner,
이세요?
Are you?
외국인이세요?
You might also hear this if you study Korean.
한국말을 잘 하시네요.
한국말,
말 means to speak. Korean speak, you. Korean speak,
잘,
well. You do. Korean speak well, you do. 한국말을 잘 하시네요.
아니요. No.
Being a little humble, 잘 못해요.
Well, I can't. I can't do it well.
아니요, 잘 못해요.
그러세요?
Really? Is that so? Doesn't believe you.
close-up section here. In colloquial conversation, you can use 지요 to confirm information that has already been discussed with the listener. When using this form, your intonation should rise up a little at the end of the sentence. The standard form is 지요, but in reality, you can simply use the shortened form 조, 조.
맞죠? 가죠?
So some examples. In the main dialogue, Yukiko is politely asking a passenger to confirm that she is heading in the right direction. Example was here.
거기, there,
마크, mark, 마크, she. She is used to politely refer to somebody. 마크, she.
집이죠.
So again, you have to go, your intonation goes up. That's in most languages when you ask a question.
거기 마크 씨 집이죠?
Is that? The blue refers to this blue here. And the response,
네, 맞는데요. 맞는데요.
Kogi. When pointing to a place, when pointing to or referring to a certain place that cannot be seen at the moment in a conversation, you can use Kogi. As in the explanation of 이 그 저 from scene 2, you can always go back to the previous lessons to relearn and refresh your memory about 이 그 and 저. You use 여기, this place, when referring to a place which is close to both the speaker and the listener.
저기,
that place, is used for places or things which are distant from both listener and the speaker. So these are places.
여기,
just here,
저기,
over there, or that place. And here at the bottom, we're going to go over the words for different nationality and languages. When a country name is followed by 사람, or 인, it means a person of that nationality. Languages of countries are formed by adding 말 or 어 to country names. So languages, 말 or 어, 사람, 인 is a person. Colloquial form.
한국 사람, 일본 사람, 중국 사람, 프랑스 사람, 미국 사람, 외국 사람.
The literary form.
한국인, 일본인, 중국인, 프랑스인, 미국인, 외국인.
Language.
한국말, 일본말, 중국말, 프랑스말, 영어.
Here's the exception where it's not following 미국말, just 영어.
외국말. 한국어, 일본어, 중국어, 프랑스어, 영어, same, and 외국어. Okay, I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Please subscribe, comment below if you have any questions, and I will see you at the next lesson.